Hey guys, how you doing? This is entrepreneur, real estate investor Curtis R. Monday, writer of the book, The Game, How to Become a Successful Real Estate Investor. Look, I'm live on site at one of the projects. And you know, real estate investing is phenomenal. And there are a lot of people out there teaching you how to real estate invest. They're promoting the benefits of real estate investing, create generational wealth, create financial freedom. And all those things are true, but I'll be remiss if I didn't share with you some of the realities that come with real estate investing. I mean, real estate investing is a contact sport. It is something for not the faint of heart. Let me give you two examples right now. One, most of the projects you do in real estate investing, you may very well deal with hard money lenders. And when you're dealing with hard money lenders, you go out and you figure out what the cost of the repairs are for the project. And they give you a budget. It's called a construction budget. And then as the project progresses, you request draws from the construction loan. So if you got a loan to do $100,000, if you did one part of the work, you may request a draw for $10,000, and then another 10 or another 15 until you get to 100. Well, the premise is that you're going to pay interest only on the amount that you're actually using at the time, right? So it helps to manage your expenses because a lot of the projects you're doing are going to be vacant. I mean, all of them are pretty much going to be vacant. So you got to rehab them to get them either occupied or sold. So only paying interest on the amount of the financing or the amount of the money that you're using at the time is a tremendous benefit. Well, again, no one knows everything about real estate investing, and there's always some different challenges and hurdles. And even with me, with the number of projects that I've done, I had a challenge with this one where the financing on this one fell through at the last minute, 2 days before the actual closing. So I bought the property cash. It was a great deal. I broke my own rule. I tell all my students, leverage, use other people's money to go ahead and get something done, minimize using your own cash, but I couldn't pass up the deal. So I bought the property cash. I found financing through a company, a mortgage broker, relationship I have with an individual, and he found me a company. They gave me the money to rehab it. I never questioned anything because I've gone through so many deals. I've gone through so many rehabs that, you know, again, a construction loan was a construction loan. So we made our first draw. We got a rehab project for $165K. We made our first draw request for $30,000. And then when I get the mortgage statement back and talk to the bank, they're telling me that I had a payment due for $1,500. And I go, well, how in the hell do I have a payment due for $1,500 when we only requested $30,000 out the $165,000? And the answer that I got was that the deal or the financing was submitted as what they call like a full loan from day one. So it was a full loan from day one. So from that perspective, what they're saying is that the juice or the interest I'm paying is being paid on the loan from day one. Now, I've never, ever, ever heard anything like that. I've never done anything like that. And so I was shocked. Called my mortgage broker immediately and in anger and bewilderment, upset about, you know, what's going on, and asked the question and come to find out, yeah, it's true that the loan interest was being paid up front and not based upon just the amount that you're using. So here's the moral of the story. You know, what mistake did I make? Well, the first mistake I made, I didn't look intently at the documentation. I kind of took it for granted based upon my experience and also the mortgage broker that I knew that it was just what it was. That's a no-no. You can't sleep because if you get sleep in this game, it's a contact sport, you get knocked out. So now I'm faced with having to carry the full weight of the loan of $1,500 while we're going through the rehab process with no one into the actual property. That can potentially jeopardize the property, but you know, we'll do what we do. You know, you can't cry about it. That's real estate invested. That's an example of kind of how this stuff works, guys, and an example of how something can potentially derail a whole project. So again, real estate investing is cool. It's a great opportunity. It does all the things you've heard people promote, building wealth, creating generational wealth. But also the reality of it is, if you are not aware of what you're doing, it can cause a costly mistake and can jeopardize a project. Now, the truth of the matter is, when I teach you guys about real estate investing, one of the things I tell you that you have to take the power away from the word failure or mistake. See, this is how you learn in real estate investing. You learn from your mistakes, you learn from your adversity. This will be a mistake that I'll never make again. And then with good sound business practices, building in a contingency in your budget, and having other reserves set aside, you'll be able to kind of weather the storm. We'll weather the storm. We got no choice. This is what we do. we'll weather the storm because it's connected to my why. See, I'm not doing this just for hits on the gram. I'm not doing this just because I just want you to big up me and say, man, Curtis is smart. No, I'm doing this because I'm trying to leave a financial legacy to my son. I don't hustle for my first name. I hustle for my last name. Chance Jordan Monday, this is what I'm doing this for. You got to have a why. This is my why, so we'll eat this. We'll keep it going. I'm eager about the other side. If you're interested in real estate investing, reach out to me at 708-505-7072 or DM me on social media. Pick up that book, The Game, How to Become a Successful Real Estate Investor at www.curtisrmonday.com. Later.